out grabbing a walk, and my plan was actually, I've been thinking of making a video of the Mavic Mini now for some time, but I wanted to wait a bit, so I at least had some experience flying it and editing the videos and trying it out in different conditions, and now I feel like I can finally do it and give an honest opinion about the drone. This is actually my first drone, and my first drone I've ever flown, period. And it's so intuitive when you start it, and I felt quite calm using it. Just when I unboxed it, I had checked some user guide videos before and what people recommend, so I downloaded the apps that I need and updated the drone to the current software and my phone, batteries and everything that was needed. And it felt so freaking nice when I connected it and started it, and just when it's just hovering there, when you just click on take off on your phone, it felt so intuitive to fly. So I feel a bit like, have you ever driven a RC car? You immediately recognize the steering. Of course it's not the same thing, because it's going from side to side, up, down, and if you fly towards yourself, the steering gets inverted. But it's really a treat to fly. I think my main concern has been, every video I've seen about it has been talking about the poor wind qualities for it. Just since it is a 249 gram drone, strong winds are definitely a problem. But in my experience and what I've seen other people on YouTube recommend, as soon as you see that strong wind warning, you should really, really listen to it and fly as safe as you possibly can. So far I've flown it not super far away from me, but I think I've flown it what can it be, like 500 to a kilometer, 500 to 1,000 meters away from me, and I went up to 120 meters, but that was on a good condition day, so there was almost no wind and it was just a super stable, calm flight. But I have been testing it a bit in really, really, really rough winds. I did a video shoot with a tattoo artist that we hopefully will release later on. And we were up on a hill and the winds were really, really rough. So the Mini was really struggling. So when I kept it in hovering position, it really kept angled at the side, just pushing against the wind, just to stay level. And I did try some tricks that other drone. Let's see, getting a bit dark when I get into the forest here. Oh, flies, there we go. I did try the tips I've read and seen on YouTube that the standard drone things that you should fly with the wind and or fly with the wind back, so you have the help of the wind, so you don't get flyaways. Specifically that day, we had, as I said, really, really strong winds, and it kind of felt like it wasn't possible to fly it safely at all. We just used it at very low heights, so like, I think I wasn't higher than, I just kept it over the ground pretty much and just had it a couple of meters in there. But I wasn't comfortable releasing it in, release it any higher, because if it was struggling like that on the ground, I would surely had just lost it if I went up even further. So, my personal thoughts about the Mavic Mini. I would say that I did get a question about if you should get the Mavic Mini or the Mavic Air 2. And when I've had the Mavic Mini, I absolutely love the Mini, and I wouldn't have gotten it in a... I wouldn't have gotten the Air first, I think, at least. Not me, but... just because I wanted to get comfortable with an entry-level drone and get some knowledge before I move up. That's pretty much the mindset I've had with cameras and everything. I want to start out at a good level, learn. So I really want to feel that, like with cameras, I want to feel that the camera's holding me back, if that makes sense. That I want to do more things, but to do them with more ease, I need a newer camera. And that's the same mindset I have with the drone. Like, the video quality of the Mini is fantastic, and I absolutely love it. The only thing I would have a bit of a issue with, not issue, but... it is over-sharping the image a bit, in my opinion. But then again, it feels so weird just saying that it's too sharp on the image. That is a thing, like... But... what I've tried, it's easily fixed. Just dampening the sharpening in Premiere Pro or what software you're using to edit your videos after. I do feel like if you're getting the Mavic Mini, I would say it's absolutely a little beast of a drone. I got the Fly More combo, and if you're getting the Mini, I would seriously recommend getting the Fly More combo, because you have the free batteries and a multi-charging station, and you get propeller guards, and it's just packed. And you did get this nice carry case for the Fly More combo, the Fly More combo bag. And what I have in it, so I do have the Mavic Mini, of course. The remote. And the free pack of batteries. That at least two is good to use at the moment. So, I was planning on setting this up. There we go. Just grabbing my phone with the DJI app. And excuse me for my cracked screen on my phone, but needs to get replaced. Oh, there we go. Starting it up. So we have that ready. And unfold the little Mavic Mini. There we go. Oh. Let's see. Full battery. Grab that one. And there we go. And removing the gimbal cover. So, I'm not using the prop guards for this because I've gotten more used to flying this little thing. So, we'll start exploring the area a bit. There we go. The little Mavic is just absolutely. I am absolutely in love with this little drone, actually. So, heading back, we're trying to find a nice spot to sit down and grab a drink and talk a bit more about the Mavic and my experiences with it. So it's really warm today, as you can probably see, sweating. So pretty much my ending thoughts about the Mavic Mini is it's a small, price-worthy drone. It can handle stronger winds than I actually thought. The video quality is really, really good. It is over-sharpening it a bit, but easily fixed in post. Stable to fly, good battery life. The range is a bit. I have never have had a lost connection or anything, and I've been flying it too close in on like 1,000 meters, so 1 kilometer. Yeah, I'm guessing that the range aren't as good as others, but when I've seen people in the US fly it, they can get quite insane distances on it and heights also, but you should stick to the regulations and just fly safe and think first that should I really do this, and just be safe so you can get your drone back pretty much. The only downsides for me is I think it's just because it shoots JPEG. I would have wanted RAW, but I didn't get this for photos because I got this for video, so I shouldn't complain, because if I wanted photos also, I should have gotten the Mavic Air 2 or the Mavic 2 or Pro. But just for video, and as I said, as a starting entry-level drone and just getting into it and start flying, this is just a treat to have. And if you're getting this, I can highly recommend getting the Fly More combo, because that extra buck, you get a really nice hard case to put it in, and the free batteries and the prop guards and everything like that. So it's I can just really recommend it. So quiet out here. Really nice. Grabbing myself a drink, just needing to relax a bit. Nature really is the best medicine you can get. It's quiet. The sun is shining down on through the trees, and only thing that's bugging me at the moment is flies, but I can live with that. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, would love it if you press like and subscribe, and if you have any questions for me or about the Mini or concert photography or pretty much anything, just leave me a comment and I will try to answer it as fast as possible. And yeah, I think I will leave it at that and continue my walk. So search for some buttons around the screen. It helps. Still here? Yeah. Weird bearded dude walking in the forest.